the sattvic concept of daily life. Namaste. Welcome to Sattvic Concept of Daily Life. Myself, Chetana Badekar. In today's concept, we are going in detail about four streams of yoga. As we mentioned in the previous videos, there are four different ways are categorized where you can discipline yourself for evolving as a better human being. So the four ways which you mentioned are Karma Yoga, Bhakti Yoga, Raja Yoga and Jnana Yoga. Let us speak about that in detail one by one. And as we start with the Bhakti Yoga, where one can evolve through bhakti, following one religion or one tradition, you are dedicating your time for the surrendering to the God. That's how the Bhakti Yoga starts. The Bhakti Yoga is one of the most famous, most easiest, most lovable way of disciplining yourself and evolving as a very superior human being. How it starts? From which stage? A layman, an ordinary person, if he want to evolve through Bhakti Yoga, what and all the stages he need to undergo? We say that in yoga, the gross love in every creature as karma. Karma is the gross love in every creature. But that karma has that possessiveness. It has affection, it has love, but with the possessiveness. You love somebody, you want to take care of them, you want to serve them, but you have a possession tendency on them. You are possessive about that. Then it will become karma. So to turn this karma in towards Bhakti Yoga, the karma should be added with the tyaga. Karma, the gross love, with the sacrifice or tyaga, it becomes prema. The gross love with the sacrifice will become love. In prema, you have affection, you want to take care, you wish to be a well-wisher, but you don't have the possessive tendency, possession tendency. Then what happens? That becomes a selflessness. There is a prema or niswartha prema, what you call it as the love without possession tendency. Still, there is a second stage of Bhakti Yoga. From prema, you have to develop into bhakti. How? So, you have to surrender. In prema also, there is no surrender. You and me, there are two ego exist. The universal energy is considered as God and the internal energy is considered as you. The union is not yet happened. The union starts when with the love you surrender. When prema with the surrenderness or the love with the surrenderness becomes bhakti. That is we call it as, that emotion is called as bhakti. There many examples are there through Bhakti Yoga people are evolved. Then one person who is coming to the Bhakti Yoga or evolving himself through the prayers, he will be having his own favorite God concept. And he will be following certain rituals and disciplines in his daily life, dedicating certain time for that particular God or Goddess. And that will be happening with the love. And there is a great surrenderness. Whenever that God concept is arriving in front of them, they dissolve their ego, they happily become flexibly accept that particular deed. So whatever they are doing, they wish to do it as a deed of that particular God. That's how through the surrenderness you are evolving. Your ego will go on settling down and you are evolving. Then bhakti in the initial stage, it will have attributes like you have particular definition or description of the God. For example, somebody is a devotee of Krishna. They have described way their own Krishna. It may be the young Krishna, it may be a teenager Krishna, or it may be a very matured Bhagavad Gita Krishna. It may be Jesus. It may be Allah. It's up to their particular choice. They will be having that dedication. Where you have a description of the God, we call it as Saguna Bhakti. Saguna Bhakti is not the final state of Bhakti. Where you are finding that devotion with the certain gunas, certain qualities. But later, you will see that God entity in each and every aspect of the life. Whomever comes in front of you, you feel it is a form of that God. You will start seeing the God in every human, every creature, every animal, every plant and every happenings of the life. Then your bhakti is not limited to a shape or to certain character. it is dissolved to the universal level. That time, the person who is surrendered to that particular God started able to seeing God in every entity, he will become Bhakti Yogi. That is called Nirguna Bhakti. The stages of Bhakti Yoga goes like this: Kama plus Tyaga, gross love plus sacrifice will become Prema, love. Love don't have possession tendency. Love with the surrenderness will become Bhakti. That emotion is Bhakti. The initial stage of Bhakti, the Bhakta, the person who is doing that, will have his attributes of the God. That's called as Guna, Saguna Bhakti. Later, he will see that energy in every existence of this life. That's called Nirguna Bhakti, ultimate merging. That time, Bhakti Yogi will be evolved himself as a superior human being, an evolved human being. In our day-to-day life, if we can assign certain time for this Bhakti Yoga or developing this Bhakti in our life, that will be a great. You just assign a time for the prayer and adapt a particular procedure for the prayer, and that itself is enough to evolve as a superior human being. And we call whoever as Bhakti Yogis, we call them as Dasa, means those who surrender their ego. We have very good examples like Mother Teresa, Purandar Dasa, or Kanaka Dasa. These are all the people who are evolved through Bhakti. All the religion through prayer, whoever evolving, that is evolving through the Bhakti Yoga. There are 9 categories of Bhakti is mentioned. Whatever the Bhakti Yogas are available or the way of prayer is available, they categorized into 9 different way. That is Shravana, Kirtana, Smarana, Padasevana, Archana, Vandana, Dasya, Sakhya, and Atmanivedana. There are different 9 forms where you can surrender yourself to God. So Shravana, by listening about the preachings of the God, repeated listening of the preaching of the God will make you to surrender yoga, that you can evolve through Bhakti. It's one way of Bhakti Yoga. Kirtana, by singing lot of prayers, praising the Lord, you can actually evolve. That is another way of the prayer. Padasevana, by doing some kind of archana, like considering God as a higher entity and doing some ritual, that is Padasevana. And sometimes Vandana, just people do the namaz as they do the namaz, and that is why you are surrendering yourself. That is a different way of Bhakti Yoga. Like that, Bhakti Yoga mentioned different 9 forms where you can surrender yourself. So this is one of the tools we can adapt in our daily life and shape your life into a better human being. That we have to assign particular time. Every day that day, the time is dedicated to that God, and you are exercising of refining yourself and evolve as a better human being just by a simple effort. That is what Bhakti Yoga explains. In the next stream is Karma Yoga. We come up about this Karma Yoga in the next concept about Sattvic concept of daily life. Till then, I'm taking it. Thank you.